Particle Illusion went 3D in version 2021, with more new features added in version 2021.5. So in this tutorial, I'll bring you up to speed with all of those changes. Okay, so let's walk through all of the key 3D features. Starting with this button up here, this is the Toggle 3D Project Settings button. So obviously previously Particle Illusion was a 2D particle generator, but now it's 3D by default. If you do want to go back to 2D, you can just toggle it here. Notice when I go back to 2D, the Stage Camera button is grayed out. Come back to 3D, and then this becomes active again. So here you can choose the different 3D view. It's at Render View by default. If I choose World View, now we're looking at the scene from an angle, and you can see there's the camera just there. And if we look at this from the top view, you can see that my particles are indeed 3D. Now the reason they're 3D is because with the emitter node selected, if we come up to the properties, notice there's an emit in 3D checkbox. If we deselect that, the particles disappear in top view. They are actually still there. We go to world view, they're still there, but these are now 2D particles. So you can use 2D particles in a 3D project, but I'm not really sure why you'd need to. And if we recheck emit in 3D, these are now 3D particles. There's a few new emitter shapes. We're on point at the moment, but there's also a new box shape. You can see that's very small on the stage here. We can drag the heads-up display to change the size of that. We come up to the world view, a little bit easier to see. So we can change the size here interactively, or we can come down and we can change the width, height, and depth in the controls. I'm just going to increase the depth. And probably come and just decrease the number of particles. The other new shape is sphere. Gives us a 3D sphere, which is really nice. Once again, we can change the size of this by interacting with the HUD, or we can come down and adjust the radius. And notice also that there's now X, Y, and Z position. So we can position our emitters in 3D space, which is really handy. To access the different camera models, what we have to do is come down to node view and click away so that no nodes are selected. And then you'll see the camera model pop-up up here in the controls view. Now this is set to none by default, and we have three choices: position, orbit, and pan. Let's take a look at position first. So position has camera XYZ, zoom, orientation, and rotation, plus depth of field. Now each of the different camera models have different settings, except for zoom and depth of field, which are constant for all three. Let's take a look at these different options. So the first is camera XYZ. I'm going to change this to top view, just so we can see this a little more clearly. Hold down the space bar, left mouse button. So there's my camera. And if I change camera X at 500, that moves the camera on the X. And we come back to, say, front view, change the Y, moves the camera on the Y. Notice how the camera moves, and nothing, we don't see anything else happening in front view. But if we change to render view and change the camera on the Y, then that slides up. Change it to minus 500, and it slides down. So make sure you're in render view to be able to see your final render result. And undo that. Now, camera XYZ moves the physical camera, whereas zoom is like a regular camera where you actually can zoom in and out without moving the camera. So if I change this to, let's say, 2000, we're zooming out. Change this to, say, 4000. We're zooming in. Now, orientation is set to free rotation by default. And I like to think of this as a handheld camera. If you're an After Effects user, you might recognize it as a one-node camera. Let's go to top view. And before, what we saw is if we change the X value, say 500, see how the camera and the camera's point of interest moves. The same for Y and Z. If we change this to point to target, which is the second option, watch what happens. Change this to 500. Now the camera's moving, but the point of interest or the target isn't moving. So if you're an After Effects user, you might know this as a two-node camera. Got one node for the camera and one node for the point of interest or target. If we just undo that and go to left view, and we change the Y, 500. Notice how the camera's moved down and it's pointing up at the target. There is a third option, point to object, but this isn't currently implemented. Now notice when we choose point to target, we have target X, Y, Z parameters. So if we change Y to say 1000, by default, our target is the center of the scene, 0, 0, 0. But we can change that. If we make the target Y, for example, 1000, now we've moved that target down. So we can move the target to be anywhere in the scene. Come back to free rotation. Notice that target XYZ is no longer available, but we have rotation. Under rotation, we have tumble, spin, and rotate. So if I change tumble, for example, notice how the camera is tumbling, but it's no longer looking at the target. This is because we have free rotation. Just come to our render view. Try that again. So our camera is tumbling and no longer looking at the emitter. If we change spin, same again. So the emitter is stationary, but the camera's spinning away from it. And rotate is the same as what you might know as bank, or banking the camera. So the position camera model is probably the most complicated. There's the most settings, and it's also the most flexible because you can do more with it. But a lot of the times you won't need all of these settings. So for that reason, there's an orbit option and a pan option. Let's take a look at the orbit option first. So the orbit option also has rotation parameters, tumble, spin, and rotate. But watch what happens when I come to top view and once again change the tumble. Notice how the camera is tumbling, but it's still looking at our emitter. Same with spin. The camera is spinning, but it's still pointing at our emitter. So this is a really nice, quick way to be able to do an orbit around your emitter. You could do the same by choosing position and choosing point to target and then changing the different camera XYZ properties. But it's much easier just to come and choose the orbit model and then just change it here. We go to our render view. And change rotate. And rotate is the same as position. It just allows you to bank your camera. The other simplified option is pan. So what pan allows us to do is change the distance. So once again, change the position of the camera, moving it in and out. We've got our zoom. And we have advance. And advance moves the camera left and right. So this is similar to coming back to position and changing our orientation to free rotation and then changing the camera X. So you could do everything just using the position camera model, but the orbit and pan options are handy for quick tasks like a 360 degree spin around your emitter or maybe a pan across the front of your emitter. And a quick tip if you're using Continuum Title Studio is that the camera models in Title Studio match the camera models in Particle Illusion. So you can very quickly set up a look in Particle Illusion and have it match the same camera movement in Title Studio. And all three cameras have depth of field. We just turn that on. and change the focus length. You see we get some lovely depth of field. We can change the aperture. Give us a nice sort of bokeh style, and also the blur strength. Forces and deflectors have also been updated to work in 3D. We come up and click on the force button to add a force to the scene. You can see that adds a 3D HUD for the force. If I choose world view here, and just change the scale by dragging on the HUD. Maybe increase the strength. You can see how that's starting to push those particles to the right. And forces also have width, height, and depth parameters that you can change numerically, and also X, Y, and Z position. Deflectors also work in 3D, but currently you'll notice that the heads-up display is only shown in 2D. Okay, so that's all of the latest 3D features in Particle Illusion 2021.5, but look out for more updates in future versions. There's also a Continuum plugin version of Particle Illusion that includes extra features in After Effects, including 3D light and layer tracking, and text and mask paths for emitters. So if you're an After Effects user, be sure to download a demo at borisfx.com, where you can also download Particle Illusion standalone for free, including thousands of free particle emitter presets.